Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java, and this is the tutorial number 6 of Android game programming. What we are going to see in this tutorial is working with multiply sprites. We're going to work with a lot of sprites. If you remember in the last tutorial, we had a sprite that each time it changed direction, it changed the animation. It was a very difficult tutorial, if you remember. This one is going to be easier. Let's start with the tutorial. The first thing we're going to do is, instead of using a sprite variable, we are going to use this one, which is a list of sprites. We come here, and in the place where we have the variable sprites, we change it for a sprite list. Shift Ctrl O to import. The next thing we have to do is, do you remember what we did in the tutorial number 4, that we copied the character but one? Now we have to copy the rest. Here we're going to download but to save image as we need to know where to save them. We are going to have to save them here. If we open properties here, we can copy the folder where the sprites are or where we want to put them. Here it is, bat 1. We save bat 2, bat 3, bat 4, bat 5, bat 6. Now good 1, good 2, good 3, good 4, good 5, and lastly, okay. Now we go back to the page 6 of our tutorial, and now yes, here we're going to copy multiplies. We're going to copy the sprites in the constructor. Instead of doing this, only one. Here we're going to include each of the sprites. To not write so much, I created a function called createSprite. And this method, which I have also here, what it does basically is I pass in by parameter. Here I have an error because I have to make refresh here. Okay, now. Okay. So I get the bitmap by passing the resource by parameter, and I return a new sprite with this, which is a pointer to game view and the BMP which I have created, and this is the one I add to the sprite. I could have put the ad also inside here. Now we need the printing. This. In the under, instead of doing just one. Let's do a for, iterating over the sprites, and we print each one. Okay, let's see if it works. Here it is. As you can see, they all start from the coordinate 0, 0. Well, this is not what we want. The best thing would be that here, instead of starting with 0, 0, we initialize these values. We could initialize them giving an aleatory number to x between 0 and the length of the screen. It is really the length of the screen minus the length of the sprite from here to here. And for E, the same. Not till here, because if not, half the sprite would be printed out of the screen, but the length of the screen minus the length of the sprite. It would be all this zone. For this, in my page, again, you can notice that I don't like to write. Here, Control S to save. Okay, run, and here we come. Okay, error. What happened? The two lines we just wrote are these ones. Let's try to take advantage of this situation and let's debug. Let's put a stop here in the two new lines and we run it with the debug. I have a debug tutorial if you want to have a look in the YouTube channel. Here we are. What is happening here? If we select this, Control Shift I to inspect, we're going to evaluate what we have selected, and the result is that the game view.getWidth is 0. What does this mean? That the length of the screen is 0? How can it be 0? The problem is that the view is not ready yet. It is not initialized. If you remember, let's stop this. If you remember when we did the first tutorial in the game loop, we put callback listener to the holder. This call the surface created when the view is created. When the view is created, the holder calls us and tells us that the view is created. This would be the moment to create the sprites because the view is already created. Instead of creating them, in the moment of creating them, we put this here. So now it's a bit nicer. We could use a method. We create a method. We're going to put all this inside a method. And we call, yes, all this inside the method. And after this, we call the method afterwards. Just before, just after they tell us it is created. Let's run it. Let's run it in debugging, and we stop in the same place. Let's do inspect. We can also do it with the right button of the mouse, going to inspect. As you can see, gameView.getWidth is 320. 320 is better than 0, no? This means the view is already initialized. So now it is already ready to work graphically. Okay, if we delete the stop and we run it, we're going to have the moment of the movement of the characters from one place to another. Let's try it once again, and here we have it again. Okay, as you can see, it's like a stress test. We have each of the characters moving with its speed from one place to the other and with the correct animation depending on the direction they're going to. Okay, we have finished with this tutorial. See you in the next one.